Hello, fellow Rosarians. So today is a very exciting day because we're going to check in on all of those David Austin bear roots that we got at the beginning of April. It is mid-June right now, so that gives us a real good amount of time to be able to see how they've been performing in my yard. So keep in mind that my results are going may be different than what you experience. I have a very unique environment in that I have very high humidity. The black spot is something that we deal with every day and we don't give it another thought. We also have high winds that come off the water. We have a very high water table. So we're going to be checking in on 54-ish roses. And if you saw the last video that I did checking in on the bare roots, I really hope that you're starting to formulate your ideas about who you'd like to order from in the fall. We had some really great analysis where we measured each of the roses. We talked about its performance, how it's done. But if you look at how those roses performed, that'll give you an idea if that's somebody that you want to consider ordering from. Some of them really outperformed the other vendors. So let's check in and see how the David Austin bare roots are doing. As we get started, I'll go ahead and let you know who did not make it in the garden this year. We had a tough time with Just Joey. Just Joey did not make it. We also lost Tea Clipper, and we lost one more, I think. Tamara, we lost Tamara. My Windermere, I'll show you. It has failed to flush out. So let's go ahead and take a look around and I'll show you everybody. So look at this pretty bed here before we get started. I've got a lot of fun red colors. There's my doggy Chardonnay, but I've got some beautiful purples in here. This is Fiji for its first bloom of the season. And then let's head down here. And I see I've got Royal Jubilee, Falstaff, Othello, the Dark Lady, and the Fisherman's Friend. Okay, so this rose right here is Gabriel Oak. That was a new introduction in 2019. And we were able to get it in the US just this past season. I'm looking at the overall height on this rose, and it looks like it's about 22 inches. And then at its widest point, 21 inches at its widest point, it's got some really nice growth here. And I believe that I have seen this one bloom just once so far for me, but very healthy shrub. I'm not seeing any black spot in this rose. So this little baby here is James Austin. He arrived at the same time. And let's look at his highest point. Now keep in mind, I have been cutting blooms off of this, so that's going to affect the height that I'm giving you guys. But just for a general idea, let's go to, this is at his highest leaf point, he is 12 inches. And at its widest point, he is approximately 12 inches. So when you figure both of these shrubs came at the same time, it could be in their genetic nature that James Austin is just slower and a smaller rose, but that'll just give you an idea what to expect your first year. Okay, so if you can see this little guy in here, ignore this beautiful bloom, but do you see he's stretching all the way over here, this rose? This is Tam O'Shanter. So we're going to make sure that when we get his overall width, we are coming all the way over to here. So he is approximately 20 inches wide. He's got a bloom here, and I have had blooms of him that I've posted online if you're interested in seeing him. Very beautiful color. So let's go ahead and get a height up to the top of this bloom, and it's 17 and a half, almost 18 inches, and he bloomed for a really long time. This rose right here is amazing, and I am so impressed. Sir John Betjeman, but if you look here at the really light blooms as it starts, and then the variegated color, it's lighter on the outer blooms to darker on that bright fuchsia. This is just a really fun rose, and I've enjoyed watching it. It's been in bloom for at least a week now. So let's look at the overall width from its widest point, and this is approximately 29 and a half, so let's say 30 inches. And then for height, let's go up to this bloom that was recently cut here. This cut is a little over 18 inches. Very good rose. Highly recommend. I don't see any black spot on any of these roses that I've shared with you. This rose here, this is Noble Antony. Now, he's been attacked by slugs, but other than that, he hasn't had any issues with black spot. He's definitely bloomed for me because I can see the cuts that I've made off of there. So let's look at his height is about 17 inches. Let's look at his widest point is approximately 18 inches. Young Lycidas. Look at this difference. It's just so amazing that you can have one that's so tiny, and then you can see another one that arrived the exact same time that is considerably larger. So Young Lycidas has a beautiful coloring that is like shades of fuchsia. So looking at her highest point, she's really only just over 8 inches. Let's look at her widest point. It is approximately 11 inches right now for Young Lycidas. But overall, she's very healthy. Looks like I've got some dieback here I need to take care of. But I see nice fresh growth coming out here. So she is very happy. Brother Cadfael, and I'm excited. I see a bloom getting ready to go this week on that. So I would say he's on the medium side. His overall height is, it looks like almost 13 inches. And it looks like at his widest point so far, he's 15 inches. So this rose right here, I see I've got one bloom, two blooms. This is Maid Marian. It's got a dimension on it first, and that's about 18 inches. And then if we're looking at the top, it looks like it's about 12 inches. A few pieces of black spot, but nothing that I'm really concerned about. So this is Pat Austin, and I got three, and you're going to see variations in the height of these. So this one here looks very happy. I don't think I've seen a first flush for this one yet with blooms. It's 20 inches, and the overall width is approximately 15 and a half. This one here is approximately 16 and a half inches or so, and I'm getting ready to have a bloom here. And then the width at its widest point is about 20 and a half inches. But guys, do you see this little tiny baby? My cameraman might need to move a little bit on this one. Look at this itsy bitsy thing that is approximately 3 inches. This is my third pat. And it just, I don't know, it has not been super happy here, but we're going to let it stay here until the fall and see if it starts to pick up, because some roses are just slower by nature. But it's happy, you know, it's got green leaves, it's so it hasn't completely died back, so we'll keep watching that one. Here is Sweet Juliet. She's got a little bit of black spot, but nothing that I'm really concerned about, and I see two buds, so that tells me that she's a happy girl. So I'm looking at the height on this, and it is about 15 inches, and then the width at the widest point is about 16 inches. All right, so this set here, I ordered three Judes. So one, two, three, and I think these look amazing. So for a first year bare root, this one is up to 28 inches. Let me check this one. This one is about the same. This one's a little bit smaller. It's about 22 and a half inches. So let's get some widths. This one is approximately 21 inches. So this one is 28 inches. And then this one is a whopping 33 inches. And look at this Jude here. She is so pretty. It's like the lightest of apricot colors. In the same family as Evelyn, Lark Ascending, Lady of Shalott, a little bit pinker hue, but all in that same family. Very pretty. So I have three lark ascendings, one, two, three. And I bought this one to round out the set of three. So she's a little bit smaller, but let's get her dimensions and we'll see. The lark ascending is approximately 23 inches. She is approximately 19 inches. So this little sad person is Windermere. I have one on each side and I wanted this one to finish out the set, but it has failed to do anything. So we'll go ahead and put in a credit request for this one and then take it out and be done with it so that I don't have to feel sad anymore. Okay, so this here is Charles Rene McIntosh. You know, he's got the same damage from budworm as a lot of my others. I have an organic garden, so I try not to use pest control when I don't need to. So this is 19 inches. The width is 16 inches at the widest point. So here we've got PAOK, also known as Princess Alexandra of Kent. She's on the smaller side compared to a couple of the roses that we've just seen, but it looks like she's getting ready for her very first blooms that I've seen this season. So keep in mind, you could get your rose orders at the beginning of April, and here we are, June, and I still have not seen blooms from some of them, and that's okay. They just take a little bit longer. So this rose is approximately 13 inches at its highest point, and the widest that I see is about 16 inches on PAOK. Otherwise, very healthy, and I'm not really seeing any black spot on this one. Okay, so I'm hoping that you can see back here my Hyde Hall. It's been blooming like crazy all week, and I have been so excited to see it do its thing. So it's very prolific. It is 16 inches at its highest point, but what's crazy is the width on it. Let me get back here. It looks like 29 inches at its widest point. So very pretty. I kind of wish you guys could see how deep this bloom is here, how it's very dark as it's opening up. Okay, so this one here does not look great, you guys. This is Scarborough Fair, and so it really has had no growth since I got it. It's 10 inches high, lots of dieback. I've got one green cane right here. I love this rose, you guys. I have taken so many pictures of it for you. The bees love it because it's more of like a single petal where it's wide open instead of the multi-petaled, and the bees, I mean, the pollinators just love it. So please consider this one. It's fighting Temeraire, and let's get a height on it. It is 20 inches or so in height, and let's get the widest point on it is about 19 inches on this rose. It's very healthy. It's got some budworm damage, but then most of my roses do. So I've got two roses here to show you. Look at this tiny little one. It's very happy, but this is Q. And when I get a height on this one, I'm looking at approximately 8 inches or so on this one. Its overall width is 16 inches, but it's got nice red growth on it. I've seen a couple of tiny blooms, maybe last week on it. This one here is Grace, and she's much taller. Looking at Grace, she's about 18 inches, and her width is about 16 inches on Grace. Eustachia Vi, 19 and a half, 20 inches, we'll give her 20. And then the width is approximately 19 inches here. I've seen her flush is really bright red underneath, but she is a very happy rose and no black spot. Here is Tottering by Gently. I've got some burnt leaves. It is so hot down here in this section, and they get full sun, but this rose is doing great. And let's get a height at the tallest point right now. It's about 15 inches. It's very full, and it is 21 inches wide. If you look here at this little baby, this one was one of the smallest ones that I got as a bare root, and I showed it to everybody also. So this one was so tiny when I got it as a bare root. It's Corvidelle, but I'm so excited to have it that I had no complaints about the size of it. It is right now 7 inches tall, and it's almost not worth getting a width on it, but it is 6.5 inches or so on Corvidelle. But otherwise, it is very happy. So I've got two of them here to show you. This is the ingenious Mr. Fairchild, and he is blooming right now. And besides having a beetle in him, he is almost 20 inches, and at his widest point, oopsie, at his widest point, he is 18 inches. And this one is fun, you guys. Look at this. This is Teresa Banier. And look at her bright green foliage compared to a standard rose that you see. I mean, it is like chartreuse. So if you're looking for something different in your garden, she is so full and healthy, but it's so fun to see a different leaf shape on this. And it's not chlorosis, you guys. This is just her color. So let's go ahead and get a height. She is 20 and a half inches, and then let me see at her fullest point. I'm seeing 21. Yeah, she's 21 inches. So I highly recommend the shrub. All right, guys, so this is Skylark, and I love how sweet the petals are on this. It's a little bit more of an open petal shape, and the center of it has those yellow stamens in there, and so the beneficial pollinators really love her. She's 16 inches, and her dimensions at her widest point is about 22 and a half. This is Queen of Denmark, and her leaves are lighter as they come out, just like the Teresa Banier I just showed you. And let's get a height on her. It looks like almost 18 inches, and at her widest point, she is 22 inches. If we look over here, this is Jubilee Celebration, and Jubilee at its tallest is 18 inches, and at the widest point, about 19 inches for Jubilee Celebration. It's kind of hard to see with the salvia next to it. But this is Wild Eve. She has Francis Meelan next to her. Approximately 22 inches high for Wild Eve. And let's get at her wildest po at her widest point, she is 19 inches. So this one tucked in right here is Comte de Champagne. And let's get a height on it. It looks like it's getting ready to push some blooms out, but it is 18 and a half inches. And then at its widest point, I'm going to say that it is approximately 17 inches. Okay, so this rose was supposed to be Evelyn, but she ended up being Pat when she bloomed, which is fine because I love Pat. And the nice hint of orange here was a nice change. So this rose will stay here. She's approximately 21 inches high, and her width is approximately 23 inches. So this is an Evelyn rose. I used to work for Crabtree and Evelyn, so I know that that's pronounced Evelyn, although some people may call her Evelyn, and that's okay too. But she will answer by either name. She's just beautiful. But her height is approximately 26 inches, and at her widest point, she is 25 inches. So she is turning out to look very pretty right now. All right, guys, so this is my Melanot, and if you'll remember when we unboxed it, I wasn't feeling real confident in the roots of the rose, so we're going to keep it in a pot until the fall, lift it out, and then make a decision if it's healthy. So this rose seems very healthy at 30 inches, and then let's go ahead and get the width at the furthest point. It's approximately 24 and a half inches for Melanot. Look at that little pretty. So this is Desdemona, and we've been keeping Desdemona in a pot also. You see I've got a very large cane over here. It's happy here besides having damage from budworms. So the height on this one is approximately 27 inches, and at its widest point, it is 29 inches. It is so humid out here, so I'm sorry if I am flushed and glistening a little bit, but I wanted to make sure that I share those heights with you so that you can start formulating your ideas. I'm going to go ahead and pop up on the screen all of the dimensions that we have now from David Austin to Raft Island and Reagan and Palatine and everybody that we ordered from so that you can start making your analysis of who you might have the best results from. I think certainly some of them have exceeded others in the height, but then you can see even with David Austin, I might have a rose that shot up to 30 inches, but then another one might only be 8 or 10 inches. So it really just varies on the variety and the conditions that it's in. So keep that in mind, but as a whole, you should be able to say in this person's environment, all of her roses performed at this level, and then be able to make your decision who you want to order from. So keep in mind, we have orders opening now for 2022. It's going to be here before you know it. So we have Chambly opening up soon, and then also Antique Rose Emporium, and then Reagan. They'll be the first three that open up. If you're with me on my Facebook page, Rose Geeks, I'll keep everybody informed when they need to be ready to get those orders in when they open. If you would subscribe, it would help me because my hope is that when I have enough subscribers, I'll be able to have the leverage to go to these companies and say, how would you like to send us some free gift certificates for some roses for my subscribers? And then we can do a drawing just like I did last week. So please, if you haven't yet, subscribe, let me know that you like the videos, and I'll plan on seeing you in the next one.